What do Batman and Jack Reacher have in common? That's right, they both use Keysi fighting method. But as cool as it looks, Keysi fighting method is plagued with enough flaws and missed opportunities that the only place it can really work is on the set of a Hollywood movie. Unlike many other martial arts, I believe that Keysi was a genuine, good faith attempt by an intelligent person to create an effective martial art. Unfortunately, they did it badly. It now suffers from two main problems that have absolutely crippled its development. I'm going to explore what these problems are, why Keysi is crippled by them, the downfall of Keysi fighting method, and its successor, Defense Lab. When it comes to Keysi's fundamental techniques, it seems like they have a severe case of trying to reinvent the wheel. There are a lot of problems in martial arts, like how to block a punch, how to close distance, etc. Combat sports already have good solutions to the vast majority of these problems. Keysi looks like somebody tried to solve these problems without ever looking at the actual answers. I will give them credit for getting surprisingly close, but they're still wrong. To illustrate this point, let's look at a few examples. The most fundamental position in Keysi, and the position that everything else branches off of, is known as the pensador. And it almost looks like a proper guard. But if you look closely, you'll find that it's actually worse. The overlapping hands means that the guard covers less space. The fact that your hands are so open while braced against your cranium means that a punch could fracture them. The height of the guard means that it protects your forehead more and your body less, which is silly because this does not need that much protection. And the pensador does all of this while being a more awkward position to throw punches from. The pensador got a lot of elements right, like absorbing strikes using your forearms, bracing them against your skull, and maintaining visibility while defending. But they're missing many of the finer details that typically develop through effective testing. Another example is the way Keysi practitioners like to slip punches. Keysi practitioners often put up a side block while slipping to the outside. While your initial reaction might be that the arm adds a layer of protection, it really doesn't because they're blocking on the wrong side. If they do this block and don't move their head, they get hit in the face. They either manage to get their head out of the way, or they don't. All the block does is add a large amount of surface area that you also have to move out of the way. And it threatens to actually scoop their opponent's fist into their face. If they slipped without putting up the block, it would actually be easier to do, and they can use that arm to throw a counterpunch. Keysi managed to reinvent the guard, but they made it worse. Keysi managed to reinvent the slip, but they made it worse. And their system is full of moves like this. Is this clearing a grip to get an underhook? Nope, it's a hammer fist to the thigh and then an elbow strike to the wrist? Yeah, your opponent definitely isn't going to punch you with a free hand that you're facing directly away from. If you're familiar with martial arts, Keysi's stance and movement patterns look like they want to close distance into a clinch, but they never actually do it. They always alter course at the last moment to deliver highly unorthodox strikes to highly unorthodox targets. The entire system strongly appears to be an attempt to reinvent the wheel without ever testing it. As a result, they've managed to come up with the martial arts equivalent of an egg-shaped wheel. It rolls, but not well. This leads me to the reason the moves are so bad, which is a critical lack of pressure testing. Failing to test your moves effectively is essentially a death sentence for any martial art, and Keysi is no exception. The two methods of pressure testing are competition and sparring. To have a truly effective martial art, you need competition. To have a mildly effective martial art, you at least need sparring. As far as I can tell, Keysi fighting method has neither. I've found no evidence of any competition, and while I can't definitively prove that they've rejected sparring as a training tool, the testimonies seem to point to the idea that they don't do it. If there are Keysi practitioners that spar, they're seemingly never acknowledged or talked about by the rest of the community. As I've covered in other videos, a lack of competition is usually more than enough evidence to accuse a martial art of being less than effective. But a martial art claiming to be effective when they don't even spar is almost laughable. Without competition, or at least sparring, the moves don't get tested in any realistic or meaningful way. This means that all of the moves you see in Keysi fighting method are purely theoretical and have never been tested in any way that can be verified. Once you realize that Keysi lacks any sort of pressure testing, it explains why the art is riddled with so many unpolished and gimmicky techniques. But hey, who needs effective techniques when you can have a super cool looking seizure in exotic locations like in a train, underground, or just outside with your friends? That's all from one video in which the music constantly cuts in and out, alternating between epic hero music and awkward silence. I love everything about Keysi marketing videos. A+. Mwah! A lot of reality-based martial arts out there are little more than elaborate cons. Thankfully, I don't think this is the case with Keysi Fighting Method. While it does seem to be an honest attempt at a fighting system, it also looks like something that a teenage boy could develop alone in their bedroom in a matter of months. It came close to figuring out a few core concepts, but because this is neither horseshoes nor hand grenades, close doesn't count. Instead, the art seems to be based on how many times you can run your hands through your hair while fighting. And despite its 15 minutes of fame, it seems to lack any real staying power. Their website lists 8 gyms in the United States that teach Keysi Fighting Method. Of these 8, 3 of them make no mention of Keysi on their website, one of them was a defense lab that is now closed, and one is actually a group of people that meet in a park. This means that there are currently 3 schools in the entire country that teach a Keysi Fighting Methods class. I would have checked on schools in other countries, but researching this actually takes work, and I can only read English. Now, while Keysi seems to be going the way of the dinosaurs, it does have a living descendant. Defense Lab is an offshoot started by one of the co-founders of Keysi Fighting Method, and it's more or less inherited Keysi's throne of mediocrity. While the split between these two spelled trouble for Keysi, it ultimately gave birth to a system that now appears to be much larger than its predecessor. Unfortunately, it has the same problems as Keysi, because it's essentially the exact same thing with updated marketing. Honestly, green block lettering is just so in right now. They've definitely added things to the curriculum, but unfortunately, those things also stink. They still use a version of the pensador and constantly run their hands through their hair, so the spirit of Keysi is still alive and well. And they still fill their curriculum with a bunch of bizarre strikes and missed opportunities.
Obviously, he's trying to cover down on this one, but look what this bar, what he's doing with the elbow there. He's going to hit the bicep, which is going to put me there, and then we'll take the head off.
Why land a right hook when you can spend twice as much time elbowing their bicep and then eating a lead uppercut? And why land a counter cross or a body shot when you could just hammer fist their forearm? And yes, this defense is meant to be used by 3 or 4 attackers that have formed a circle around you. Say what you will about Keysi and Defense Lab, but they certainly don't lack confidence. And just like every other bad martial art, they also have to pretend they know how to fight on the ground. And why get feedback from anyone that knows grappling, even if all of them are going to tell you the exact same thing? They're just jealous of your sick moves. To be fair, it's clear from their website that Defense Lab is smarter than Keysi ever was. By not including websites, addresses, or contact information for any of the locations on their map, they made it virtually impossible for me to fact-check which ones actually exist. It also makes it rather difficult to actually take classes at any of these locations, but at least they have their priorities straight. And while we're restricting information, let's stop those pesky grapplers from being party poopers by disabling all our comments! And hey, why stop there? Go for the trifecta by erroneously associating yourself with a more recognizable brand of Krav Maga despite it being well documented that you're Keysi Fighting Method based. And then add the cherry on top by advertising yourself as the science for self-defense despite a complete lack of any pressure testing. Unfortunately, this is genuinely good marketing. It's not honest marketing, but it's good marketing. Ultimately, Keysi Fighting Method was a product of its time. A cool-looking hard rock fighting system that peaked sometime in the mid-2000s and has been on life support ever since. Defense Lab, on the other hand, managed to update its marketing, business model, and social media management while keeping the same ineffective concepts and techniques. Keysi and Defense Lab techniques do look cool on a screen, but if you want to learn how to fight, maybe do some sparring.